Hi guys, and I hope you're keeping well. Today I'm going to be demoing how to launch and configure an EC2 instance. And in particular, it's going to be a Linux instance. So I want you to imagine that we have the following requirements. We need a web server. It must be on a Linux machine. It has to be configured with the Apache web server on it. And we need to be thinking about cost, it needs to be inexpensive, and we want it to have a public IP. So what I'm going to be doing is, and as you can see in my screen here, I'm using the AWS Educate account again, and what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be spinning up this instance. So let's get started. So what we're going to first of all do is we're going to go to the EC2 dashboard. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to services. I'm going to check how I'm doing here with regards to my dashboard. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to fire up an EC2 instance. So let's have a look. So as you can see here, there's not much going on in my account. I'm terminating my machines as I go along to avoid my credits being eaten up. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to launch instance. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to select, as you know, we want to keep the expenses down. I'm going to keep it very much to a small instance. I'm going to choose first and foremost my Amazon machine image. So again, this is going to be my operating system. I'm going to ensure to select Linux this time. Also, what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep this very, very small, keep it minimum. A T2 micro is absolutely perfect. Again, 1 gigabit of RAM is absolutely fine. And we've got an EBS volume. We'll choose that. That's cool. Now, in this particular section, if, for example, I had my own VPC, my own subnets, I'd be looking at this and I'd be thinking, okay, I need to put this in a certain place. For now, though, we're going to keep this to all of the defaults. And potentially in the next video, what I'll do is I'll start to talk more about all of these different options and go into a bit more details. But for now, I'm pretty happy. The only thing that I want to essentially adjust here is I want this, for example, to come up or to appear when, for example, the machine comes up and running. I want it to have a web server up and running, and I want to be able to access this web page. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy and paste over a simple bash script. And what this is really essentially what it's doing is it's installing, it's enabling, and it's starting the Apache web server as soon as basically the machine starts. You'll also notice here I've got just a very simple message that will appear on the web page. Okay, so once I have this is called bootstrapping the server, by the way, and this is basically we're sending in some user data that will allow this web server to start when we power up the server. So the next thing what we're going to do, guys, is we're going to go to next, and our root volume is absolutely fine. It's going to use just 8 gigabytes of storage. That's perfect. One thing that I always like to do is I like to add a tag. So I'm going to say name, and I'm going to just call this Greg's Linux server. Okay, or Greg's web server. It's absolutely fine. I'm going to configure the security groups. Now remember, the security groups allow us to communicate with the server, and they're like virtual firewalls. So at this moment in time, I've got SSH permitted to everyone in the world. What I'm also going to do is I'm going to call this Greg's Linux Server SG Security Group. And what I'm going to also do, guys, is, well, actually, no, I'm going to leave this off for the moment. I was going to add a rule for HTTP, but I'm going to leave that off just to show you, and we'll change that later. So for now, I'm going to click Review and Launch, and I'm going to launch this instance. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to basically create a new key pair. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new key pair. I'm going to show you. So I'm going to call this Greg's Linux Server. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to download that. So what's going to happen here is I'm going to download this, and what we'll have to do in a few moments is we'll need to change the properties of it. But for now, that's absolutely fine. I'm going to launch the instance. We'll give that a second to launch, and I want to go to view instances so that I can see that this instance is launching. So this is going to take obviously a few moments. This is launching in the in this default region, which is North Virginia in my case, because I'm in this AWS Educate account. So I'm going to, that's going to take a couple of moments. So you might remember that I didn't put a security group for web. So I haven't opened up this instance to web traffic at the moment. So when this indeed does boot, it should be booting with a web server starting. So when I click on this, we might start to see some properties, and indeed we do. But you can see now I'll wait until it's running and it's gone through a couple of the status checks. But what we can also, what we can see already is that it's got the public IP address here, you can see. I can see the subnet it's gone into, the VPC, the virtual private cloud. But what I'm interested in is I'm interested to see, can I access that instance? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy that public IP address. I'm going to open up a new tab and I'm going to paste that in. Now what we're going to see is that this indeed isn't going to work. The reason why it's not going to work is because at the moment we're not allowing HTTP traffic to travel into this server. Okay, so eventually this is going to basically give us an error. So we let that spin for a little while, but eventually it's going to tell us that it didn't load properly. So what we're going to need to do then is we're going to need to go back and change the security group rules. Okay, so we'll let that run for a second. Eventually it's going to essentially time out, and we'll give that a second or two longer. Still spinning. Be nice to show you this message. Still going. Give it. It's still trying to reach that server. Eventually, it's going to give up. But just while it's still going, again, we're not seeing the status checks. But this also, I like to have a look at the information that it presents here. We see a lot of important information like the availability zone. There's the public IP. The public DNS, there's the public IP, and we can see monitoring in this case has been disabled. I can see the security group, so that's what I'm going to be editing just very quickly. I can also see the key name. So again, these are all kind of important details that it's good to keep an eye on. Now, again, if I go up here now, I can see, look, this page isn't working. So what I'm going to do, guys, now is I'm going to go back here. I'm going to go to my security tab for my server, and what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to click on Greg's Linux server. And what I'm going to show you now is I'm going to show you basically us editing the security group rules. So I'm going to edit the inbound rules, and because this is a stateful rules with security groups, I'm going to add a rule, and what I'm going to say is simply HTTP. So allow HTTP traffic. So again, it automatically sets port 80 for me, that's perfect. And what I'm going to say is I'm going to use a default all to basically say I'm going to allow everyone. And once I do that, I'm going to save the rules. Now you'll notice here, guys, at the moment you can still see it's still trying again, still trying to locate it. When I click save rules, we may actually see this loading. Let's give it a try. Let's just wait. Let's see, it's still trying here at the moment. If I refresh my page now, in just a moment, I can see that those inbound security rules have been modified. Let's refresh our page. And I didn't even need to refresh our page there. It actually just appeared, guys. So we can see our web server is now live. We can see that it's now worked. Okay, so the only other thing that we could actually demonstrate here, guys, is we also had a rule here for SSH. So for example, if I wanted to SSH into the server, it would be a simple matter of just going back to my instances, okay? And what we can do is you can either go through the actions menu here or right click. So what I could do is I could click connect. And in this case, what I can do is I can use SSH. So here I can see it gives me a number of steps to take. So you can see in this case, it says open an SSH client. It basically says that you need to obviously go to where your Greg's Linux server.pem file is located. I need to change the permissions. So again, I need to change permissions before I can connect to it. But as soon as I do that, it should allow me. So what I'm going to do is, guys, I'm just going to move this file that's downloaded here. I'm just going to pop that into another folder here. So I've got a folder called, and let me just bring this up so I can show you. So what I've got here, guys, on my desktop is, let's just bring this up nice and big. So what I've got here is I'm going to go into my desktop, and what I've got is I've got a basically a folder here called AWS keys. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to list the properties just for a moment, a long listing of the properties for Greg's Linux server. Okay, so what we can see at the moment is I've got read, write, I don't have execute permissions for me, but you can see there's also some other permissions. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to run this command to change the permissions so that essentially I'll just have read permissions only on this file. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just copy that, make my life a little bit easier, just pop that back up, paste that there. And essentially what that's going to do now is it's going to change the permissions. If I just run that command again, what I can see is that it's changed the permissions now that I've only got read access to it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use that command SSH-I, and I'm basically saying here is the key that I'd like to use. And essentially I'm going to be logging in using the user ECT user, which is the user for this Linux based AMI. And I'm going to try and attach to this basically server. So you can see at the moment, the first thing it's saying is the authenticity of the host is basically this. It can't be established. Would you like to continue? And I'm going to say yes. So now, guys, what I've got is I've got access now to my basically EC2 image. Okay, so I'm now on the image itself, so I can do ls. You can see, okay, so let's do a PWD. I can see where I am. I can also try and ping out. So let's try and ping Google's DNS server. And as you can see, I've got internet access. Okay, one other thing that you could check, for example, guys, if I just bring up another window, just to show you the power of these, of security groups. Let's imagine I wanted to ping this server. So if I go back to the instance, very quickly, and if I just get my running instance, just find the IP address of it there. Let's grab that again. And what I'm going to do is just bring up those command prompts. So this is me on my Mac computer at home. Now what I can do is I can try and ping that public IP address. So this isn't going to work, guys. Why not? Well, at this moment in time, I'm only allowing SSH and HTTP traffic. So these are going to fail. But if what I can do is, so they're all failing now at the moment, but what I could do is I could go back to my security group. So let's go back into security. What I can do is in here, go into security, edit the inbound rules, and what I could do is add another rule. So in this case, I'm going to add an ICMP, IPv4, all rule. Again, I'm going to allow this for everyone in the world to ping this server. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add that rule. Now, before I save the rule, let's just keep pinging the server for a moment. Let's minimize that. Let's bring that out over here. And once I click on, say, let's hit the up arrow and ping. Once I save these rules, guys, what's going to happen is it's going to start allowing these to come true. Let's click save. Let's bring this up. And hopefully what we should see, and there we go, guys. We now are seeing pings. So I'm pinging from my computer over to this EC2 Linux image in the cloud. Okay, guys, that's all for this particular video. So what we did, just to summarize, we launched an EC2 Linux image into the AWS cloud using our AWS Educate account. What I did was I launched a web server when it started. What I then did is we saw that I couldn't connect because the security group rule wasn't there. We added a HTTP rule. I then basically SSH'd into the server. I needed to, before I SSH'd in, I needed to do a change mod on the permissions of the file. Once I did that, it allowed me to access the server. And then what I did was I did a further test allowing ping traffic to access my server in the cloud by modifying, again, my security group rules. Okay, I hope that was helpful and see you next time, guys. Thanks for viewing.